Hey friends, I'm Chris, and I'm a program manager on the NuGet team. Today I'm going to try to answer the question, what is NuGet? But before we start, if you're just arriving here and you're completely new to the concepts of .NET or libraries, I highly recommend you check out the .NET Core 101 series before continuing. Otherwise, so what is NuGet? NuGet is the official package manager for .NET. That means we provide a platform and tools to help developers create, publish, and consume .NET packages. So if you're wondering now, okay, so then what's a package? Packages can generally be thought of as compiled libraries packed together with descriptive metadata into a nice shareable unit. So you might recall from the .NET Core 101 series that a developer platform like .NET can generally be defined as the combination of its languages and its libraries. NuGet's job is essentially to make those libraries as accessible and easy to share as possible in the form of packages. NuGet lets developers leverage an entire ecosystem and build on top of existing solutions instead of building everything from scratch. To get a better idea of what NuGet is and the sheer scale of the ecosystem it helps support, let's go check out NuGet.org. NuGet.org is the central repository for .NET developers to find and publish .NET packages. You can see that there are over 100,000 unique packages with billions of downloads. These include packages to do almost anything you can imagine at .NET. IoT, gaming, cloud computing, image processing, machine learning, it's all at the edge of your fingertips. You'll also find links to documentation as well as the NuGet blog so that you can keep up with the latest developments in .NET package management. Now, with that said, why don't we go check out some packages? This is the kind of page you're going to see whenever you're searching for a package, and you'll see that NuGet surfaces a lot of useful information, like a short description of the package, the total number of downloads, the last time it was updated, of course, the owners of the package, whether or not it's verified, and the unique package ID. If we click on the ID, we see even more package-specific information, like a link to the project site for the library, a link to the repository so you can check out documentation or see the source code, the license that it falls under so you know about the restrictions associated with its use, as well as any repositories that are depending on it. And if you ultimately decide, all right, this seems like the perfect package for me, you can see installation instructions for various different tools on the center of the screen. Now, NuGet also provides tools to help developers right where they work. So if you're a Visual Studio .NET developer, then you'll love that NuGet package management is built right into Visual Studio. So you can browse for packages just like you would on NuGet.org and see a lot of the same information surfaced. And whenever you install a package, you'll be able to see all your installed packages for the project in the Install tab, as well as get notifications for updates whenever there's a new version available. Now, if you're not a Visual Studio developer, or maybe you develop on an entirely different platform altogether, you'll find that NuGet commands are also built right into the .NET CLI so that you can add, remove, or create new NuGet packages wherever you develop. All right, so that was a really quick introduction to all things NuGet. In the next video, we'll talk about how you can install and use .NET packages with Visual Studio. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.